Yes, why I retired in end of 92 is, it was quite early because I was only 23 years old. But actually, racing here in America for me was like the end of my career. It was, my goal was to be one, to be American champion. And so I was world champion in Europe, 125, 250, and my life goal was to be American champion, Supercross. When I did it in 91, I have so many, it was, for me, it was like so big achievement. Then I knew I cannot do better anymore. My heart was, already, planning something else. I want to race in road racing world championship. I have a lot of things to do. And also it was very hard for me to race here, over here, because I was the first one, European to come to race in America. And it was not so easy at the time. It's not like now. Now it's a lot more easy. The world is more open. Before it was like quite, very close. So for me it was like, okay, this is done, and I did what I want to do, and it's time to stop. My French friend, Purcell, that's the only one who tried to ride, to be smooth and to try to go fast, but going fast, but not trying hard, and that this is the only one I saw in the last few years to be able to ride like we were riding before. Roxanne is the only one who is able to do it. Before was only French people, because we have a Supercross championship in France, so all the French guy at this, I start first, but all the French guy want, the goal was to come over here to race, and it spread a little bit in Europe, and actually Roxanne is the first guy outside France to have his dream to come over here and to race and to win race here. So I think it would be the, he can do it. I start to ride motorcycle for the first time at 10 years old, and it just, after riding and riding and riding, it get better and better and better. And I don't know if it was just talent or if it was, practicing and get better and better every day. But yeah, actually I was, it was very easy for me to ride on a Supercross track. I didn't feel like I have to work very hard. And people were jealous, maybe because it looked like it was easy for me. So people were trying very hard to try to go as fast as I was going, and I was going the same speed, and not, not, it doesn't look like I was working hard. So it's hard for people sometimes when they work very hard and they have to fight against somebody who is just doing it like, look easy. It's not easy for me, but it looked very easy. So yeah, I understand that people were, a little bit jealous, but that's the way it is, and I work hard to try to get better when I was young. So maybe that's why I was maybe a little bit better after, I did many things in my life, and since the last 4 years, I race a little bit car in Europe, rally car. So, but now I have a Audi TT. Yeah, I stood, when I was young, I studied many riders, and David Bailey was my hero. But I have also, like Ricky Johnson, when I was looking at him, like, he was very good and, winning everything. So when I came over here, my goal was to beat him. So, and he was at the top of his career. And so that was Ricky Johnson for sure. Oh, difficult question. very difficult. First, I will feel difficult to fight against Roger De Coster team. So I will try to take Roger with me. That's the first thing. And I think after that, I will work with him. And the bike is not very important in a team. It's people. When you are in a team, if the people are very positive and they put a good energy in a team, everybody is working so hard, then the result is coming. So people are more important than bike in racing. Jeff Stanton. And actually, yeah, Stanton was the best guy to fight against, because he was always keen, and he was very good. So, Bradshaw was also a good fighter, but he was sometimes too, a little bit too much. He was trying too much, and he was a little bit dangerous. So, of course, we have a lot of fight with Bradshaw, but it was not fun to fight with him, because we never know what he's gonna do. But Jeff was always very good, and you can be sure that he's not going to do something crazy. So that was better, more easy. Roger, Roger was very important to me, because first, I was racing in Europe, and he knew that my goal was to race in America. But at this time, it was it was a big war between Europe and America, so it was difficult for me to find a ride and a team. So Roger, did everything for me. He opened the door for me at Honda, and that was very nice. And also, he was happy to bring somebody from Europe in a Supercross championship, because he loved racing, and he don't care if the people are French, American, Japanese. If he just want to see good racing, and I think this is a good good thinking. And so when I was racing here, Roger always helped me a lot, especially with a fan, because for me, I always tried to protect myself, because it was not easy to be in a state and to race here, and to be people was not so nice with me, so always try to be to secure myself, to put a wall between people and me, to try to only be 100% in racing. And when I was going a little bit too far, Roger always told me, okay, this, you have to be nice with people, you have to show that you are happy to be here, happy to race here. And for me, it was not always easy to do it, but Roger helped me a lot in this way, I think. And I'm still very friend with him, and because he did a lot of things to me, and that make a big difference in my career. And I think, if we talk about Porcel, he did a little bit the same thing that I was doing, because for us, for French people to come over and race in the US, it's not easy. So I think Porcel did the same thing. He just tried to protect himself. He put a wall between the fan and him and the team. And the problem when you do that is you try, you get away from everybody, and you're always alone. So at the time, Roger helped me a lot to not go too far. When I was going too far, he always said,